We're joined today by State Representative Steve McCarter, and we're talking about gun violence and opportunities to try to reduce the number of people killed every year. And it's amazing, 11,000 people were killed in the United States last year by a gun.
It is amazing, Kevin, that, you know, we've had a terrible time, really, in the United States of dealing with the issue of violence. And violence in this particular case caused by weapons, by guns, has been something with us for a long time. And the American tradition is something that we're going to have to deal with. We can't ignore it forever, but it's a conversation that has taken a long time to develop and will take a long time, I'm afraid, to solve as well.
Yeah. Well, the numbers, again, in Pennsylvania, over 500 people were killed last year by gun violence. 300 of them, more than half of them, were in the city of Philadelphia, in the Philadelphia region. But now there are some proposals to try to make Pennsylvanians a little bit safer.
That's correct. Obviously, with the number of deaths in Pennsylvania and in the city of Philadelphia and the throughout the Commonwealth, we have to attack this. Newtown has shown us that assault weapons, again, are a problem, and that's something that we're going to have to address. How we do that in Pennsylvania is going to be a longer conversation, though. We have a long-established gun tradition in Pennsylvania, and that's something that has to be honored, I think. At the same time, we have people who are becoming frightened on a daily basis of the amount of weapons that exist in our society. That has to be addressed also. So we have to look at sensible legislation that deals with that. We have to deal with criminal background checks and getting Pennsylvania on board with the national movement in that direction to follow through on the federal legislation so that everybody who registers with a gun, that information goes forward. We have to close the loopholes, and thankfully Attorney General Kane has been able to do that and part of Pennsylvania now. So that's two of the areas that we have to address.
Well, are there some bills out there, some legislation that's moving its way through the legislature that has you a little bit concerned?
Yeah, there are some. Surely on the Republican side that have been put forward that, for instance, would arm teachers. I spent 35 years in a classroom, and I can't think of anything, quite honestly, that would cause more disruption and cause more concern than really trying to arm teachers, even ones who feel that they are trained or have been trained. I spent six years in the military, and I'm very familiar with all the weapons that are available. At the same time, I can't see that as a means by which you're going to have increased safety within schools.
Well, are you concerned about the high-capacity magazines or the ability, to, as I call them, the cop-killing bullets?
Well, I am especially concerned with the high volume magazines. At the same time, I'm cognizant of the aware that there is a change now beginning to take place with the way in which those magazines can be made. It used to be that they had to be manufactured by a manufacturer. Now, however, with 3D printing, there is the capability of people making those in their own home. So control of those is going to be extremely difficult as we move forward.
Well, you know, we've talked about a lot about the variety of gun violence, but are colleges and universities, that's something else you're concerned about?
It is. There's nothing that we can, you know, we must come up with ways to deal with safety in all of those particular locations. That's where the mental health issues come into play. We have to deal with that issue. We have to be able to have significant reporting in which to make sure that these weapons and so forth are controlled.
Yeah, and there's a House resolution that would study the issue and come up with recommendations.
It is. That's a House Resolution 53. We'll be moving forward. Hopefully, we'll be dealing with that in the next few weeks to establish this commission to make some sensible recommendations back to the House to be able to deal with the issue.
Yeah. Very important topic. Thank you to State Representative McCarter for joining us.
Thank you very much, Kevin.